talk about optical clocks towards 10 to the minus 18 to 10 to the minus 19. No units given. 10 to the minus 19 times the age of the universe. But maybe before I start, I just tell you a little bit about my own personal journey, both with five slides and clocks. You know, this is all very interesting, but what you're most interested in is hearing about me. Perhaps especially interested hearing about various people that I've worked with throughout my career. And I think that's particularly interesting if you don't know them. Some of you that I've worked with. So, five slides, I think I've been with five slides for about 10 years now. The first five slides competition, I presented John Armstrong's slides. I had a memorable experience there, and then I presented Brad's slides a couple times. So I've done a lot of slides. And there are I also think that in presenting five slides, I think the slides fall into three categories. There's the slides where there's a perfectly coherent talk that anybody could give. And just talk just gives itself. That's never happened to me. There's category two, where the slides make no sense at all. And just hung out to dry. That happens when you get out of dry. And the third category is when the slides are about something and you have this feeling that you're supposed to know something about that thing, and you don't. I have to sort of, what should I say, sort of stall for time. Talking about something unrelated. So we'll see which category as we go along. So there are many candidates, good candidates, for optical clocks. I think there are square ones, there are round ones, triangular. Perhaps some sort of direct optical microwave coupling based clock would be really good, and that would maybe get you down mid 10 to the minus 17s. If you're really searching for the 10 to the minus 18s, I don't know if that's going to do it. So, yeah. All right. How am I doing on time?
You've got 4.5 minutes.
Oh, okay. So on the left there, we have a graph of the detuning and the effect on excitation fraction. And you know the resonance around the detuning is zero, right? It tells you that you've got perhaps a clock that could work. And in the middle, you've got some sort of long, skinny thing. some parabolas. Really, to get a good clock, you want to have your VGG somewhere below your VEE and your VEG. That's really going to get you. That's, you know, if you're looking for 10 to the minus 19, that's where you need to be, so please keep that in mind. No. Suppose you want to use a strontium lattice to make an accurate clock. Do you have the budget? We have enough strontium 87 to do that. Well, it really depends on the lattice Stark effect relative to BGG. That's what it is. So there you go. All right, how am I on time?
You got 2 minutes and 45 seconds.
Perfect. Yeah, I mean, so you got your smart chip, sure. That's like the bronze standard. Why? You're turbine. That's a step up. I'll save the surprise for the end. But turbine is obviously stable. So here we have comparisons of two identical turbine clocks performed at NIST. That's a place where they do clock stuff. And 2013. And you can see on the graph that the lines point in the same general direction. So, up to the left. So.
You got 90 seconds.
90 seconds is just perfect. All right. There we go. Oh, okay. Ooh. So, in the flat Earth weak field approximation, okay, otherwise, the big U would be much, much greater than 1. And we get approximately T sub D is 1 plus GH over C squared in that case. And that puts us right in the 10 to the minus 18 S's, give or take, an S or two. That means that the cube is clearly the superior design relative to the circle or the triangle. So there's your gold standard right there, 10 to the minus 18. It's of course, still moving towards 10 to the minus 19. Very exciting field. For those of you who are still, pursuing your studies, this would be something I'd recommend. All right. Questions?
We've got time for one question.
Students first.
Yeah, yeah. Colleen.
Well, obviously, all these slides will be made available on the internet, so I don't think we need questions about this material. Questions about me or about some colleagues I've worked with. Welcome those.
Let's give Dr. Englefield that.